Hello there, welcome. I am the Empire Gamer, and this is Prince of Persia The Two Thrones. Now, I'll admit that I have skipped the second game in this trilogy, but my problem is the Warrior Within. It's a good game, don't get me wrong, but I don't enjoy it as much as I do The Two Thrones or The Sands of Time. Also, I've only completed Warrior Within once, maybe twice, whereas The Two Thrones I know a lot more about, I know a lot better. And to be perfectly honest, there is just more to it that I enjoy. So, without out of the way, let's start my playthrough of The Prince of Persia, The Two Thrones. It's quite an interesting one, to be perfectly honest. I do enjoy it. Though one of my favorite parts about the games is that it's all told as if as a story.
Some are small, some are large. But his mistake, born of innocence, fueled by pride, was the greatest and most terrible of them all.
It always is.
All that is yours is rightfully mine.
Some believed when the prince journeyed to the Island of Time to escape death that he returned alone. The amulet destroyed, the Dahaka appeased, the empress dead. The prince was free at last. But this is not how it happened. The truth is that he chose to save me from my destiny. In doing so, he set me free and doomed us all.
That is always the case.
Prince, of all the possible futures, this one held the most promise that something has changed.
Do not worry, Kailina. No harm will come to you in Babylon. I promise. Look, we are nearly...
Not make promises you cannot keep. Especially when it's been too long since you lasted. Since you lasted. Why is his ship moving? Oh wait, he's returning from the Isle of Time. My apologies. It would have been easier if I had. But
Kailina! Kailina!
She is the Empress of Time. And creator of the Sands of Time. There is backstory involved, but it's understood fairly simply by the time you get to it. Especially if you listen to the background bits and pieces that occur.
As our ship lay sinking in the harbor, the prince found himself in a city quite different from the one he left behind. The normally busy wharves were now decimated. Blood-spattered awnings and splintered door frames were all that waited to greet him. And the people, merchants, beggars, fishermen, were nowhere to be found.
Coming he expected.
Others had taken their place.
There she is. Not the best welcome to that.
Let her go!
The prince made his way along the torn and blasted district, haunted by visions from his past. The dockside tavern where he'd spent many late nights was now reduced to cinders. Babylon's proud armada, which he would often come to greet, lay cracked and broken. pass to the bottom of the Euphrates.
Unfortunately, the controls are exactly the same as in the previous games, which is very convenient because I don't have to worry about relearning controls or learning new ones. But there is a change in the circumstances about...
Well, everywhere there are signs of battle.
Not even halfway through.
What of Babylon's guard? Where have they all gone?
They have not gone anywhere, my prince. They are all dead. Now, I'll admit that during my first few playthroughs of this game, I did have a walkthrough guide, just to make sure that I picked up as much as I could, found everything that I could. And as is the case with, in the previous game, the fountains were only for recovering health, not saving. But you could get upgrades to your health through magic fountains. In this one, it's not quite so simple. There are puzzle-filled hallways to find. And that is one of the things in the walkthrough guide that I used. But I shall do my best to avoid using those, resorting to the guide. Next time. I will still try and find as many of the health upgrades as I can, but... enemies. This could be interesting. Well, this is quite an entertaining commentary.
Why is it that every time disaster strikes, I find myself without a proper blade? Still, it's better than nothing.
That is a reference to at the start of the Warrior Within, you end up on a beach with a chunk of wood. Now, each different enemy type that you can face has a different animation on the stealth kill. My personal favorite is the archers. It's quite an acrobatic stealth kill. And entertaining as well. Of course they can. And another element that was included in the in Warrior Within is the secondary weapons. Pick up from fallen enemies. It's quite useful. Especially because they can be used to throw. As I'm pretty sure there are some enemies in this game, as the Warrior or Warrior Within, that are specifically weak to thrown weapons. Can present a problem if you throw your weapon and miss, but it's more useful than you think. However, the secondary weapons do degrade over time, which can be quite irritating. Depends on how much you use them.
Kylina! No! No way into the city now. I will have to climb the siege tower and enter from above.
Yes, you are. Can't go through there. That was a little bit more difficult than I expected it to be. It has been a while since I played the Prince of Persia game, so that is my only excuse. May not be much of an excuse, but it's still an excuse.
Where was I?
I can sense the others who have passed through this place, intent on bringing harm to my family.
Not just your family, my friend. People.
4 weeks I've been at sea, and every day spent dreaming of my return to Babylon. But never, in all my visions of the future, did I suspect a homecoming such as this. War. It is the only answer. But war with who? And why?
And here is the archer. Because the archers are so much more lightweight enemies, they don't require quite so many hits to kill. I do still find it amusing that he didn't see me there. But those helmets really don't help. It's kind of amusing in the process.
And from here when you return, you should know that it was not love that drove him. But duty. I was his responsibility. He had made a promise that was now broken and undone. As with all mistakes he had made, the prince meant to fix this. A noble goal to be certain, but a selfish one as well. For he was motivated to ease his own pain.
As ever, he simply wants to prevent things from going wrong after he made the mistake. If he makes a mistake, he fixes it.
I know
quite
these
often.
Streets. Knew them anyway.
In his attempts to fix things,
I must keep pace with
worse.
Kylina if I am to find the one responsible for this.
Unfortunately, I didn't get the timing right for that, because if you're really, really good, you can get a double speed kill, double stealth kill. So, you can actually get to the point where you're bouncing between two enemies. It's actually quite an entertaining way of killing people.
Go!
Okay, let's try this again. Okay, I can do that. Let's see if I can go. There we go. Even that, wall run. Almost always works. Okay, let's try this again. There we go. And whilst I'm here, I think I'm going to call it a day. Thank you very much for joining me. Please leave me a like, perhaps a comment, subscribe to the channel. It would be an absolute pleasure if you did. I have been the MPD Gamer, and hasta luego.